my apprentice. Delicon eliminated and Lord Rathori dispelled. This will be a day long remembered. The loss of Haladril Sitson is unfortunate, but the ends far justify the means.
She served you honorably, Master.
I had a soft spot for her as well. You have successfully eliminated both of my compromised agents. The time has come to set our sights on Noman Carr and his gifted Padawan. It seems our adversary is of like mind. Your efforts have not gone unnoticed. Noman Carr has been busy.
Enlighten me, Master.
It appears your ship is being tracked. A very sophisticated sensor is reporting your every movement. I've traced the signal to a spaceport in a sector not far from you. I'm sure Noman Carr is involved.
It seems likely.
I've sent the coordinates to your mainframe. Head there immediately, dock with the station, and make a lasting impression.
What seems to be the trouble, Hiroshio? Tell me why you're so concerned.
Master Carr, you promised we would be undetected, but the ship we've been tracking for you is here.
Calm your fear, Hiroshio. It will not serve you. I will speak with your visitor when the time comes.
The time is upon you. I am here. Say your piece.
Okay. You never told me we'd be tracking a Sith.
You were provided the details necessary to perform your duties. Now please, remain quiet. Sith, I presume you are Darth Barriss's new apprentice. I am Jedi Master Noman Carr. Do you know me?
Will you be disappointed if I don't?
I have a long history with your master. Barriss and I like to keep tabs on each other, so when I heard of a new apprentice, I investigated. These men were merely monitoring the equipment, following orders. There's no need for bloodshed here.
I do not bleed my enemies out of need, Jedi. I enjoy it.
How sobering. Getting this first-hand look at you tells me much. I see no need for further pretense. Let's speak frankly. I know Barriss has spies, and I know you were sent to extract two of them before they could be exposed. But I'll soon have the proof I need. Barriss's spies can't hide for long.
Your pupil's powers are a sham. She is leading you on a witch hunt.
You know more than I thought. Barriss, no doubt, is after my Padawan. How unfortunate. I've kept her identity and location a secret. So you and your master are just feeling your way in the dark. But my Padawan is of supreme importance to me in the Jedi Order. I will not let harm come to her.
I'm going to keep her skull as a trophy.
Clearly there's no reasoning with you. Hiroshio, let me show you why there was no cause for concern. These troopers are among the Republic's finest, and you leave me no choice. Men, take the Sith in, by any means necessary. Seems Darth Barriss has found himself a singularly vicious weapon in you. This experience has given me valuable insight. I'll be prepared for you next time, Sith.
I'll wait right here, Carr. Come and face me now.
Jedi do not seek out a fight. My place is by my Padawan's side, teaching her the ways of the Force and honing her talents. I will do everything in my power to keep her hidden from you.
I'm talking to a dead man.
Until we meet again.
Apprentice, now that Noman Carr realizes that we seek his Padawan, there's no time to waste. He claimed the girl on her home planet of Alderaan, and she trained on Tatooine. I have agents on both planets digging up leads. Find the people who know this girl. Someone means enough to her to make her come out of hiding.
I will obliterate everything she knows.
I am confident this is how we will prevail. The Padawan's training is incomplete. She is susceptible. The anguish you cause will flush her out, and you will kill her and her master.
As you decree, my lord.
This will be a great test for you, apprentice. You have yet to face a Jedi master. The righteousness and passionless demeanor is nauseating, and Noman Carr is no ordinary master. confronting him, you will find profound fortitude and hate, or you will falter.
Save the rhetoric. Let me get to work.
Learn to heed my wisdom, or you will die. Be off, then. Tatooine and Alderaan await. Discover this Padawan's identity and destroy her. Sands of Tatooine await you, apprentice. I've gleaned much since our interrogation of the Republic agent here on Dromund Kaas. I am certain Noman Kaar brought this gifted Padawan to Tatooine to train with a legendary master named Yonlok. Years ago, I urged the Dark Council to hunt down and destroy this Jedi. They refused, and Yonlok went into hiding on Tatooine.
What should I do with him once I track him down?
Yonlok is the one who brought the Padawan's powers into expression. Now they share a special bond. Find him and destroy him.
I will bring the old man to his knees.
Noman Kaar shelters his prize, so we will draw her out by destroying everything she loves. My servant Sharok Biv will guide you. She is eccentric, an acquired taste. But give her the benefit of the doubt.
As you decree, my lord.
That is all.
The harsh sands of Tatooine welcome you. I am Sharok Reeve. Our lord and master Darth Barriss bid me to impart my knowledge of this planet and help you track down the Jedi Master Yonlok.
Barriss is only my master in name.
I did not mean to offend, my lord. You and you alone will be my master during this time.
See to it, you remember that.
I will waste no more of your time, then. You will find Master Yonlok by tracing the path the Padawan and her master took. I can tell you where they started. I followed them to the forbidden lair of the ancient sand demon, a terrible beast. The Padawan left her weapons and entered alone. Impossibly, she returned unscathed.
Now you've got my undivided attention.
The Sand Demon is the fiercest creature on this planet. You don't just walk into its lair and return without a scratch. I investigated further. The beast was there, also undamaged. And what's most perplexing, its skin was glistening.
Somehow, she avoided fighting the demon.
That appears to be the only conclusion. What happened in that cave is a mystery. As is where the Padawan and her master went afterwards. There is one man on Tatooine who might be able to explain. Isabo Jeef. He's as old as the sand. Part madman, part soothsayer.
I want to talk with this man immediately.
It will not be easy to speak with Jeef. The small farming settlement where he lives has been overrun by Exchange thugs. The Exchange hates the Empire for running them out of Mos Eila. They will allow me to pass, but they'll attack you on sight.
They won't see me coming until it's too late.
Then I will meet you at Isabo Jeef's hut.
The world is weeping, and the tears evaporate in the heat of our sins.
I think you mean from the heat of our sons, Isabo.
No, child. There is a dark presence newly arrived on Tatooine.
Ah, Sith. You made it. The hostiles outside were no match for you, I see.
They tried to stop me. They failed.
Failure can be contagious, and hard to dispel once contracted. You are the seeker Sharok spoke of. You wish to understand the Jedi's purpose in the lair of the Sand Demon.
You see it correctly.
My eyes may be aged and failing, but my mind sees.
Please, Isabo, make haste. Tell my friend what you know. I will remain here after to hear your wisdom.
Fine. Gather close. Few are aware that Tatooine was once a place of positive force energy. Jedi made pilgrimages here to renew and purify. The sands speak of a ritual called the Demon's Blood. This is likely what the Jedi that Sharok witnessed was engaged in.
Explain this ritual.
The Demon's Blood. A Jedi seeking enlightenment would cover himself in fresh sand demon blood and enter the village of the Savage Ones. Cowering before the demon slayer, the Savage Ones would reveal the path to self-discovery and to that which the slayer seeks.
You mean the sand people?
Tatooine makes most who come here savage. And the sand people have been here all along.
Isabeau, as I told you, the girl faced the beast but left it unwounded.
There must be another way to bathe in the beast's blood. But you'll have to discover that for yourself, if you care to. To know where this Jedi girl went, you'll have to perform the ritual yourself, and then see if the Savage Ones speak.
It's not much to go on, but it will do.
That is everything I have. If everything is not much, then perhaps nothing is everything.
Here are the coordinates you will need. After you face the Sand Demon, I will meet you at the Sand People compound. If the legend is true, and the Sand People have something to offer you, I wish to see it with my own eyes.
Can we talk for a second? I really don't have a good feeling about this.
I need you focused here, Vette.
Sorry. I just have an irrational aversion to attacking monsters that can swallow me whole. I'm thinking, if the Jedi perform the demon blood ritual without a fight, there must be a way we can too. As a favor to me, could we please get through this without mixing it up with the sand demon?
I was already planning on doing that.
Oh good. That's a relief. Looks like it's showtime. The monster's caught a whiff of us. I'm ready to back you up if it goes badly.
I yield to you, demon.
Yuck! So much blood! If I knew we were gonna literally bathe in it, I would have waited outside. And the smell. Oh, Cag, we're gonna stink for days. What if it never wears off?
It will be all right, Vette.
I sure hope you're right. I take a lot of pride in my hygiene. So, let's get out of the stink pit, huh?
I trailed and observed your descent here. I could not believe my eyes. The sand people all ran from you. What transpired inside the Sand Demon Cave that makes this so?
It was an epic battle, and I killed the beast.
You have bathed in the demon's blood. Its essence fills the air. Now, Isabeau said that this is where your path will be illuminated. But there doesn't seem to be anything here. Wait! On your guard, Offworlder. One of the Sand People approaches.
I'll take that.
I've never seen one of the Sand People approach an outsider in peace. This parchment the Sand Person brought is remarkable. It is a crude but very clear map of the desert. It marks a door carved into the wall of the Desert Wound Ravine. But I've mapped this ravine and there is no such door.
If this is where the Padawan went, I must follow.
I shudder to think what awaits you there. The ravine marks the farthest I or anyone I know of has dared venture. Here are the coordinates. I will follow stealthed, using the dune's shadows.
You have lost your way, Dark One. But I have come to correct your course. I am the embodiment of your greatest potential. I am what you could be if you overcame your fear and walked in the light. Impossible. You're trying to trick me. Only someone riddled with fear lies to himself. The light eliminates the need for such fear. Let me prove that I am you. We hunt Nomen Kar's Padawan, who can see the true nature of anyone. Our master, Darth Barriss, fears that this girl will expose his network of spies and bring about his demise. I accept that you are the light side of me. So what?
So, I am here to save you. If you persist down this path, your life will be consumed by paranoia and fear. Betrayal will wait around every corner. You will never know whom to trust.
I like it that way.
But you might like the alternative better. You see, the dark side seeks to subjugate the Force. It treats the Force as an adversary to be used and manipulated. When you embrace the light, you meld with the Force, become part of it. Then true clarity and peace can be achieved.
I have no interest in clarity and peace.
Then you are blind to where true power resides. Look at our master. If the dark is so potent, why is Darth Barriss deathly afraid of a young girl? Noman Kar's Padawan is merely a nascent champion of the light, and already she strikes fear into the heart of a dark side master.
That's why I'm going to destroy her.
If you refuse the light, you must strike me down. Do you have it in you to kill part of yourself?
Let's get this out of the way.
Come then, take me on. You will discover the light inside you cannot be vanquished. You have proven your way is strong and viable. With this victory, our essence has been purified. In the clarity of this communion, a vision of our destiny on Tatooine appears. Can you see it too? An encampment hidden in the farthest reaches of the desert, past a rock formation called the Forbidden Pass.
Tell me more of this.
There is no doubt this is where the Padawan went. This is where the Great Master helped her powers become expressed. The image fades. Find the Forbidden Pass and confront Master Yonlok beyond it. Our journey on this planet ends there. Farewell.
I cannot believe what I just witnessed. Did you just tell yourself to venture beyond the Forbidden Pass?
Tell me everything you know about this place.
I am chilled to the bone. The desert beyond the Forbidden Pass is an area that no one can survive. No one! Even the Sand People dare not go. You mustn't go!
Your concern for me is unnecessary.
This is not some silly superstition. Those who go beyond the Forbidden Pass are never seen again. I will not. I cannot follow you there.
I needn't waste any more time with a coward.
How that word burns me. I will return to your spaceport and update Darth Barriss.
Master Yonlok, the Sith you've been tracking is upon us. Retreat to safety. I will take the intruder on.
No, Yuli. Control your feelings. Stand at my side. I will face this trespasser. Come no farther, Sith. I have been aware of your pilgrimage here. You are a fascinating and contradictory example of your order. I know why you've come. Master Noman Kar's Padawan threatens you somehow. You seek to flush her into the open and silence her.
You figured it out.
I will not allow it. It won't be the cause of her exposure. She came to me for guidance, and the bond we struck was the most profound of my life. We are psychically linked, she and I, and I have already warned her about you. She will not fall for your manipulations.
I assure you, I can be very convincing.
Your will may be great, but hers is greater, and mine is unrelenting. The disparity in our capabilities is equal to the disparity in our age. You cannot win. Turn away now.
I've come too far to stop now.
What does it matter how far you've come, if your life ends here? In me you face a full Jedi Master, and Yuli has greater command of lightsaber combat than any Jedi Knight I've trained.
Color me nervous. Have we ever faced a full-fledged, card-carrying Jedi Master before?
The Jedi have no idea how lethal you are, Vette.
I sense that's a bluff, but no matter. Your compatriot's query is moot, as you will be facing us on your own.
Well done, Master Yonlok. Now please, retreat and let me face the Sith.
Your concern is appreciated, Yuli. But I did not seize the advantage here to immediately relinquish it.
You don't fight fair, Jedi.
When the stakes are this high, I am bound to do whatever it takes to preserve the order. Now for the last time, will you stand down?
I don't respond well to threats.
Enough of this! It's useless to reason with the Sith. Hold your weapon, Sith. I beg you.
Yuli, stay your tongue.
No. She is just a Padawan. You are a great master. I must bargain for your life. Sith, I'll tell you everything I know, if you spare Master Yonlok.
Your devotion is remarkable.
I'm sorry, Master Yonlok. But I must do this. Her name is Jaysa Wilsum, and Noman Carr has taken her to...
Yuli, you have no recollection of the Padawan this Sith seeks.
I have no recollection of the Padawan this Sith seeks.
Now, sleep. I do not relish wiping Yuli's mind like that, but his feelings for me got the better of him.
Most impressive.
It is a terrible thing, a last resort. I had to act for the greater good. Jaysa is special, her power unprecedented. If untouched by the likes of you, she has the potential to lead the Jedi to greatness.
I'm going to do much more than touch her.
You know Jace's name, but that is all you'll get here. So you may as well kill me. I must find tranquility, so Jaysa will sense only peace when you strike me down.
I'll grant you that allowance. Just tell me when you're ready.
You are a surprise, Sith. But if you think allowing me to find peace will make Jaysa susceptible to you, you are mistaken. There is no death. There is the Force. I am ready now.
Be at peace, Master Jedi.
Well, the rumors are true. Being paralyzed is a blast. You put on quite a show. I knew you were good, but,
Hope you enjoyed yourself.
Not at all. It was infuriating not being able to wipe the sweat dripping from my nose. So, Sharik said she'd be at the ship. She thought we were done for. Can't wait to see the look on her face.
Her doubt was an insult.
She just didn't know any better. She will now, though.
I never expected to see you again. Does this mean you ventured beyond the Forbidden Pass and found Master Yonlok?
The mission is complete.
This is a great lesson. The only barriers that exist are the ones we create in our minds. I will never again assume that I know all there is to know, and I will explore the entirety of the Tatooine Desert without reservation.
You have learned much from this.
I hope Lord Barriss knows how fortunate he is to have such a fine champion shepherding his cause. I shall never forget you.
I bid you farewell.
Safe travels, my lord. If you're ever on Tatooine again, come and see me.
Ugh. I hope we never come back to the sandy inferno. It's bad for my complexion.
You have done admirably, apprentice. Your time on Tatooine was well spent. Noman Carr's Padawan Jaysa Wilsum no longer enjoys anonymity. I am very pleased.
Make sure the engraver for her tombstone has the name spelled right.
No. There will be no evidence of her existence. She will be buried in an unmarked grave. Your handling of Master Yonlok has sent our enemies a clear message. Noman Carr and Jaysa Wilsum now know they cannot hide. It gnaws at the Master, and will bring his prized Padawan to her knees.
I cannot wait to get my hands on them.
I believe that moment is rushing toward us. Only Alderaan remains. Jaysa Wilsum's homeworld. Go there immediately. I will contact you when you arrive.
Thank you.
You know, I never thought much about being a Twi'lek when I was younger. Even on Ryloth, there were lots of other types of people. As far as I could tell, people like me were just the ones who made the best slaves. Wasn't much to be proud of, you know?
Your perspective changed as you got older.
It wasn't getting older. It was meeting Twi'leks that weren't helpless. When I left Nocturne's gang, I joined up with a group of Twi'lek artifact hunters. They were all young, too. Full of fire and Twi'lek pride. Out trying to recover our heritage.
I could see the appeal of young, excitable Twi'leks.
You should have met them. There was a girl they called Taunt. She was beautiful. Everyone loved her. I made friends in the new gang. But it wasn't until we did our first job together that we were family. There was this rich Dura scumball, Katabliss. Obsessed with Twi'lek women, artifacts, clothes, anything. We took him for everything he was worth.
That's quite a haul. I assume your little gang lived well for a while.
Not really. The Twi'lek groups who bought the artifacts weren't exactly rich. But we survived. Anyway, we were flying high. Did a couple more jobs together. Then came Korriban. And I guess you know how that ended up.
Apprentice, I see you've touched down on Alderaan, Jaysa Wilson's home planet where Noman Carr found her. Excellent. You will discover everything you can about this Padawan and destroy everyone she loves there.
It is a certainty.
I hope your results will confirm your confidence. Unfortunately, with the civil war for the Alderaanian throne raging, your contact, Duke Kendo of House Thule, has become unreliable. Kendo was supposed to find Jaysa Wilson's family for you, but it seems he's distracted. You must undistract him.
Why don't I just kill him?
No doubt someday the man's usefulness will be exhausted, but today is not that day. Kendo is a political creature. The consequences of failing me are abstract for him. Once they are made concrete, he'll cooperate. You'll find him in the House Thule executive chambers. Make haste. You lack patience, Duke Kendo. There are standard procedures that must be adhered to.
Your disregard for our family rules is appalling. You are an abomination. Goodbye, cousin.
Fools. They won't be feeling much of anything for long.
Duke Kendo, Darth Barriss sent me.
What? You're not on my schedule. I don't appreciate being interrupted. Barriss isn't even on my radar, Sith. I have a war to wage and personal ambitions to achieve here.
I'm here to adjust your radar.
A threat? You see these Sith I have attending me? Your corpse will be my message to your master. Femres, make this intruder a distant memory, will you?
I'm sorry, Duke Kendo. We are assigned to protect you and support your interests in the struggle for Alderaan. But we serve the Emperor first, and we will not cross Darth Barriss, or his apprentice.
It's good to know some people have respect.
We consider you an ally, friend.
Okay. That was unexpected. It seems I may have been hasty regarding your master's needs. How can I make amends?
You can start by bowing to me, too.
Of course. Consider it a small demonstration of my repentance. I pledge the same level of focus that had me so absorbed in my own work. I pledge myself to your directives, and as I aid you, perhaps you'll be moved to help me in mine.
We'll see. Time will tell.
I am focused and at your service. As I recall, Darth Barriss wanted information on a young Alderaanian girl who was taken off-planet to train with Jedi Master Noman Carr. I was to locate her family so that you could, well, send the girl a message.
That is my understanding.
The truth is, information about this girl is difficult to come by. I managed only one lead. Noman Carr's Padawan fits the description of the former handmaiden of a noblewoman in House Alder named Lady Renata. I've questioned her already, but Renata is protected by House Alder's greatest champion. The man has never met his match in melee.
There's nothing I can't handle.
If I may, once you've eliminated her protector and gotten what you need, I would personally be very indebted if you'd arrange to have Lady Renata brought to us for questioning.
I'll take it under consideration.
All right. I just hope the mood strikes you. While House Alder is a small player on Alderaan, it is affiliated with House Organa. Therefore, Lady Renata's estate is in hostile territory and very well defended. Be cautious.
Be ready for my return.
I do hope to see you soon. Until then...
We have intruder.
Lady Renata, I seek the family of your former handmaiden, Jaysa Wilson.
What's this nonsense you're spouting? I don't know what you're talking about.
Lady, let me kill this Sith like the last one Duke Kendo sent.
Windred, you don't need my permission to kill an enemy that comes barging through my door. Make it fast.
Stand down, Windred, or you're dead.
Sith got it wrong. I make you dead. Baby, I... sorry.
This can't be. I'm sorry I ordered him to kill you, Sith. I hope you don't hold it against me. You see, I've been fending off Duke Kendo's advances for some time, and I just assumed you were here for him. If you're not working for the Duke, I'll gladly cooperate. You mentioned a girl, yes? Jaysa someone?
Jaysa Wilson. Kendo told me she used to be your handmaid.
Kendo is a liar. I was aware of the young handmaiden who left Alderaan with the Jedi Master, and I did hear the name Jaysa Wilson, but you're mistaken. I didn't know her. The girl never served me.
Do you know anything about her?
Duke Kendo can include that in his interrogations. The Duke congratulates you on your impressive venture into House Alder. I'm here to take the fair lady to him.
No! Don't let him take me to that pig! I do know who the girl worked for. I'll tell you all I can, if only you'll keep me from Duke Kendo.
You have my attention.
Then we are agreed. Good. Before she left with the Jedi, Jaysa Wilson was the handmaiden of Giselle Organa of House Organa. They were inseparable. Before the war, Giselle was an aristocrat like myself. Now she leads the Organan troops against House Olgo.
Where exactly is this Giselle Organa?
Her headquarters are somewhere on the front line.
The Duke will know where to find Giselle Organa and how to reach her. If you let me deliver Lady Renata to him, I'm sure Kendo will happily shed light on the situation for you.
I'm afraid I'm forced to hand you over to Kendo.
I thought by telling you what I know, you'd show mercy.
Your destiny lies with the Duke, woman. Be nice to him, and maybe he'll treat you well. I meant what I said. I'm sure Kendo can help you find and confront Giselle. You should consult with him on it.
Be sure he's prepared when I get there.
Of course, friend. I will see you at House Thul. Come, Renata. Time to face your fate.
And a terrible fate it will be.
...for delivering Lady Renata for me. She will prove to be most... useful.
Tell it to someone who gives a damn.
Just expressing my boundless appreciation. So, Fimrest tells me the lead was fruitful. Although Lady Renata was not the girl's mistress, she knew who was. Giselle Organa. I should say, General Giselle Organa. Now you have to track her down, which poses a bit of a problem.
Some elaboration is required.
Giselle Organa leads the Organa War against House Ulgo. Her headquarters is protected by an impenetrable force field. No firepower can breach it. The force field allows Giselle and her advisors to be stationed very close to the front and maintain a more hands-on command.
There's got to be a way to penetrate the force field.
Well, that is the task that faces us. Wait! Yes! A force field needs power to maintain itself, yes? So, if we manage to cut the power, And I bet I know exactly where Giselle is getting her juice. If I'm right, you could just walk through the front door.
Let's cut to the chase.
Almost all the power on Alderaan is supplied by the planetary generator. Giselle must be piggybacking the system to power her force field. Several of my fellows do this to maintain their special security needs. A precise charge at the generator will force failsafes to fire. The planet won't miss a beat, but ancillary systems like Giselle's force field will have to be manually reset, which could take some time.
What do you think of this plan?
Me? Wow, you want my opinion? Cool. I'll tell you, I just don't trust this guy.
What a charming creature you are. Believe me, this is the only way to gain access to the Organa headquarters. Femres, fetch a 7/7 detonator from my arms cabinet there, and give it to our friend.
As you wish.
The Alderaan power generator is located above the Strait Valley, and it boasts the planet's most advanced security systems. You'll have to fight your way in, set the charge, then fight your way out before the boom. It won't be easy.
I'll try not to yawn too much.
Once you've detonated the generator, you'll still have to wade through Giselle's surrounding army and invade her headquarters before her force field is reset. I'll be eagerly tracking your progress. Good luck.
Our standing army outside is being wiped out. Someone or something is on its way here.
My technicians almost have the force field reset, but we're still a sitting duck.
There have been several assassinations of House Thule officials whose security systems were down by the generator explosion. In my opinion, House Ulgo is behind all this.
Your opinion is about to change. I'm here for information on Jaysa Wilson's family.
Intruder!
Giselle, get behind me.
None of you panic. I'll handle this. Sith, did I hear you right? You've perpetrated all this in search of my former handmaiden?
You figured it out.
Like me, you'll stop at nothing to achieve your goals. You have decimated my forces outside. They were to be deployed to secure a part of my front that's about to fall. Now I have no reinforcements. You seek information only I have, and my front needs bolstering. Perhaps we can help each other.
I'll defend your front, but tell me what I wish to know first.
I am not so gullible. I'll tell you about Jaysa Wilson's parents after my front is defended. Now, on my left flank, there's a tunnel between my forces and House Ulgo's that has been hard-pressed by the enemy. I have only a ragtag troop defending this tunnel, and Ulgo is about to attack. You must repel the enemy forces.
I will accomplish it.
It is strange to say to a Sith, but you have my and House Organa's thanks. What's left of my forces at the tunnel choke point are being led by Lieutenant Dargus. I'll let Dargus know you're coming. He'll contact me as soon as you've succeeded, assuming you do.
Your lack of faith is an insult, Giselle.
Believe me. I know you're my best chance. Goodbye, Sith. As uncomfortable as it is to say, I hope we speak again soon.
All right, man. This is it. With the captain dead, it falls on me to rally what's left of us. I guess the reinforcements aren't gonna make it. We'd better get ready. Ulgo forces are fast approaching. I can feel the tunnel walls shaking.
Consider me your reinforcements. I'm here to help.
Lieutenant, we've been flanked.
No, wait. General Giselle sent word that a Sith would be coming to our aid, but I thought I must have misheard her.
Sir, I'm not trusting a Sith, no way.
We're drastically outnumbered, Sergeant. The General's given an order, and besides, without help, we die for sure.
The rest of the men and me aren't sticking around for a suicide run.
You'd only get in the way, anyway.
Follow me, men. Only a fool fights where there's no chance of victory.
I don't think so, Sarge. Maybe with the Sith at our side, we can repel the attack. Yeah, and I don't relish the idea of being a deserter anyway.
Glad to hear it, men. Sergeant, you are relieved, and I will report this to General Giselle personally.
Just kill him, Dargus.
I won't take an Organa life. It's not our way. But he will be punished, and he'll have to live with the shame. Get out of here, Sergeant. Let the real soldiers fight the good fight.
Lieutenant, the Ulgo forces are coming now. What do we do?
Stay out of my way and watch.
Take your positions. This is it. That was amazing. They just kept coming and coming, and you, you're a war machine.
I have yet to meet a challenge I can't conquer.
You might want to stop all the chatter. Those bozos are regrouping for another attack. Get ready.
Let them come. They'll find I'm more than their match.
Here they come. There's blood all over me. It's everywhere, everywhere!
Calm down, Lieutenant. Your wounds are superficial.
Hey, I just snuck a peek into the tunnel. There's a heap of those laser brains getting ready for another swipe.
Let's stay sharp.
Get ready to be overrun. It's a miracle. The Ulgo forces are retreating. You did it.
Too bad. I was just getting warmed up.
If that was a warm-up, I'd hate to see the main attraction. I'll get General Giselle on the holo for you. She'll be very relieved.
What's the word, Dargus? I assume that since you're hailing me, the day is won?
Yes, General. The Sith single-handedly turned back the entire attack.
Sith, as painful as it has been, it seems you've come through. I hope you're not expecting a thank you.
I want what you promised.
Yes, well, a deal is a deal. Now, I promised to tell you where Jaysa Wilson's parents could be found. They have been servants in Castle Organa for many years. Sith, the Wilsons are simple, innocent, hard-working people. They deserve your mercy.
I'll take it under consideration.
That's all I can ask.
Goodbye, Sith. And thanks for saving my life.
General Jessel's warning was true. The Sith has come for us.
Men, rally around me. The fight is upon us. I didn't think a single assailant could make it through Castle Organa's defenses all the way here to us.
I didn't even break a sweat.
Consider yourself warned, Sith. You will not harm Parvin and Gregor Wilson. I vow it.
I disavow it.
Please, if we really are the cause of all this death, I want to know why.
Fine. Say your piece, Sith. I'm not going anywhere. And I will protect them, no matter what.
I'm here to do things for them, not to them.
Then there's no need for further violence. Sith, what is it you want?
Gregor, this has to do with Jaysa. I just know it.
Yes, I'm here because of your daughter.
I knew she shouldn't have gone with the Jedi. Now the Empire is hunting her. Sith, Jaysa was our life. She was going to marry Organa nobility so that we would no longer have to be servants.
When she left, we sacrificed that dream. We don't know anything about Jaysa now. We were told we would probably never see her again. We are mere servants. What could you want with us?
You will be my message to Jaysa.
You just want us to give her a message?
No, Gregor. It's our deaths that will be a message to Jaysa.
Listen to your wife, Gregor Wilson. Her explanation is very likely the truth.
Please, Sif, is there any way to inspire you to spare us?
Nothing springs to mind.
No! I've never seen a Sith kill that way so quickly. I had no time to intervene. My confidence and ego made me lax and led to their deaths. My failure will only be remedied by bringing you to justice.
Only your rage can defeat me. Unleash it.
Yes. My shame must be eradicated.
Apprentice, the Sith Fenris who attends to Kendo was able to patch me through to you directly. Excellent. I am seeking an update. News of your search for Jaysa Wilson's family has reached me, and I am quite concerned.
No need to be concerned. I've killed her parents.
Ah, I see. It appears I have been misinformed about your status. Then all is well. Good. No doubt the Padawan is twisting with grief. You eclipse my greatest hopes for you, and prove you belong at my side. which makes my susceptibility to Duke Kendo's gossip about you all the more foolish.
Are you going to tell me what that maggot said, or not?
First off, Kendo said that you set an explosion that caused the death of several Thule dignitaries.
I'll kill that worm.
I assume then that wasn't the case. Shouldn't surprise me. Kendo also said that you helped the Republic defend their front in Organa's war against House Ulgo, painting you as a traitor.
Doing so expedited my mission.
Well, I do not care about the trivial war on Alderaan. All that matters to me is that your mission is complete. For whatever reason, the man has taken it upon himself to slander you. I have no further use for Duke Kendo. Punish him however you please. If it were me, he'd pay severely.
I'm interested to hear what he has to say for himself.
Do what you will, but quickly. Until we destroy the threat of Jason Wilson, nothing else is important. Goodbye, apprentice.
Come in. I heard of your success, and I'm so very pleased for you.
Cut the antics, Kendo.
Is there a problem?
You're my problem.
You've spoken with your master, I see. I can explain. I realized when you blew up the power generator, several of my rivals would be exposed. So I seized the opportunity to eliminate them. I had company when I was speaking with your master, and I needed to keep my fellow house members blind to my maneuvering.
That is a lie. You contacted Barriss yourself, alone.
Lying to me was your last mistake.
I only wanted Barriss to know that I was looking out for him. It was harmless. I knew you would succeed, and all Barriss would care about was that. Please don't kill me. Fimres, you and your men are assigned to me. If I am attacked, you must defend.
If Darth Barriss's apprentice decides you die, we will not intercede.
Kendo's going to die. You can count on that.
It will be a pleasure to be relieved of this assignment. Can we help at all?
I don't need any help.
No! You're supposed to protect me!
He was a sad and twisted waste of space. Serving him was torture.
Consider yourselves set free.
Now we report back to our master on the council. We will be paying attention to your exploits. Farewell.
Crushed Alderaan under your boot, apprentice. I am incredibly impressed. The planet will feel the sting for years to come.
I better be earning much more than your accolades.
When all is accomplished, the benefits will be considerable. Noman Carr's Padawan can no longer hide in anonymity. I am pleased. By rooting out this Jaso Wilson's parents, you have reached across the galaxy to strike a sharp blow at our enemies. Every lead followed perfectly. Every planet ravaged. Our adversary is growing antsy. I can feel it. Expect news soon. Barriss out.
You're never gonna guess what I've been doing. No, don't try. I'll tell you. In between jumps, I've been checking holo frequencies. And I found the old gang. They're on Nar Shaddaa. They weren't leaving messages for me in the old spots. I thought they got themselves caught, or dead, or something.
That must have been very nice.
Was that you trying to be polite? Old gang's been on the run since I've been gone. Apparently our mysterious informant for the Korriban job was that scumsucker Kata Bliss. Bliss sure got revenge for the job we pulled on him. Fake mission, fake cover story. I'm thrown in the slave pens. And he hits the gang hard.
So you could say he was our matchmaker?
You are so weird. Once they escaped the mercenaries, Taunt and what's left of the old gang spent their last credits tracking Kata Bliss's movements. That Duro snake has managed to get his hands on the Star of Kalaun. It's a priceless piece of Twi'lek history. I want to get it back.
Tell me where we're going, and I'm with you.
You're fantastic! Kata Bliss is at the spaceport on Nar Shaddaa. trying to line up a buyer. I'll send a message that we're coming. Make us out to be interested buyers. Oh, and I'll tell the gang to get ready to receive the artifact. Bliss has some famous Kalish bodyguard they call the Virus working for him these days. But that's not gonna worry you, is it?
Twi'lek apajam kamgam. Amka nemnang. Ampa nemnang memua inok. Raka kem you amkam nemnu. Namgan bak umnok kijak.
What did you call me?
No, not possible.
Laboram amka. Mamni nika. Nagnaya mamni kamgam.
And over the Star of Kalaroon, this goes easy.
Umnuk kepum.
I hear.
Ibegap gamka, gakyum. Glak nimo amya galak.
I don't understand what's happening. Am I supposed to be intimidated? Amused?
Katablis, you have exploited my people, stolen our artifacts, and committed numerous crimes against Twi'lek the galaxy over.
Kama nahinga nak aka. Manalak lagi napi kibaraka.
We're full up on ugly.
Memua pemguana. Kumia yang me yang nilama. Rogon nila. Memkirikam komi manak. Memyuka hal hal krama. Niknoga nilalu mem nilak.
Katablis, you have exploited my people, stolen our artifacts, and committed numerous crimes against Twi'lek the galaxy over.
Umnuk inu memnu, amka kam mem pirulak palak.
Return the Star of Kala'an. Promise to reform, and we may show mercy.
Inik maraka, nayanaram, kam kalu amka manik.
I'll grab the Star of Kala'an. We can meet the old gang here on Nashada. They'll make sure the Star ends up in a museum. In Twi'lek hands.
Well, look who the act dog dragged in.
Taunt! Guys!
And this must be the handsome Sith you've been seeing the galaxy with. Impressive.
I've already got all the beautiful Twi'lek women I need, thanks.
Oh? You're... I see. Well, good luck cracking that safe.
Am I missing something?
Just jokes, love. Don't sweat it. Shall we talk business?
The Star of Kala'un is in the case. Authentic and undamaged.
Chiktahopa!
Got that right. Most important single blow for Twi'lek pride. All you, Vette.
You've done something great for your people here.
Cha'amo, into otman gisa. Mitisa tabarena?
Here. It's every credit we could scrape together. Don't worry, we should be able to sweet-talk the museum into getting us some of that back.
Oh no, I know you guys. You won't even be eating. You have to buy equipment, bribe fees. We don't need your credits, do we?
They are your people. It's your choice.
Then I say keep the credits. Have a big dinner for me. Get some new gear.
Kunto kororja.
No, I've found a place. I'm gonna stay put for a while, but I'll keep in touch.
You've at least got time for a meal, right? Let us show Sith a good time?
Nobody celebrates like Sith celebrate.
Hiknagumba!
Stukasun kanji tavutaya.
I missed you guys. I'll say hello whenever I can.
Be well, love. I'll miss you.
Watch your back out there, kid.